Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Stir up your power, O Lord, and with great might come among us. And because we are sorely hindered by our sins, let your bountiful grace and mercy speedily help and deliver us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to him with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
A long time ago, in a town called Nazareth, there lived a young woman called Mary and a young carpenter called Joseph. They loved each other very much, and they also loved God very much. Mary of Nazareth was very special, and an angel named Gabriel came and asked if Mary would be the mother of God.
Mary, you are the chosen one. Soon you will have a baby boy, and he will be the Son of God. You will call him Jesus.
When Mary was pregnant, King Herod gave the order that everyone should return to the place they were born to be registered. Joseph was from Bethlehem, so they prepared their donkey and went on their long journey. Once they arrived, the time came for Mary to have her baby. There was no room in the inn, so Joseph and Mary went out to the stable among the animals. She gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in the manger. Joseph named the baby Jesus. At that time, outside the city, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Suddenly, a bright star came into the sky. The light was an angel sent by God.
Do not be afraid. I am bringing you good news of great joy. A Savior is born to you today.
Hooray.
Go to Bethlehem. There you will find a child wrapped in cloth laying in a manger.
And suddenly there was an angel, a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising to God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace to his people on earth."
When the angels had left us and gone into heaven, we said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see what the Lord has made known to us."
They went quickly and found Joseph and Mary and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they told everyone, and all who heard were amazed. Studied the stars. They were called magi. One night they saw a new, very bright star shining in the sky. They knew this meant something great had happened, a foretold ruler being born. They thought the new ruler would be at the palace, so they went and saw King Herod. He was very angry because Herod wanted to be the only ruler. He told the magi to go find this new ruler and report back to him.
When it was time to set out, the magi followed me, the bright light they saw in the sky.
When we came into the stable, we saw the child with Mary, his mother, and we kneeled down and worshipped him. Then we offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. We were warned in a dream not to return to Herod, so we decided we would leave for our own country by another road.
You remain so young and tall.
this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through prophet Isaiah. Look, the young woman shall conceive and bear a son, and they will name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Let us pray. Most holy and blessed one, you sent your beloved Son into the world as a newborn infant. May the simple manger remind us of your arms that hold us.
May Blessed Mary remind us of her mothering love of it. May steadfast Joseph remind us of her fathering love. May a friendly beast remind us of the goodness of all creation.
May the watchful shepherds remind us of your care for us. May the journeying magi remind us of the gifts we give and receive. May the glorious angels remind us of the astonishing news, the birth of our Savior. Amen.
Good morning. Welcome to Grace Church. If you are new to us, a special welcome. We're thrilled you're here for our weekly nativity pageant. Some of you caught that. We only do this once a year, but I love it every year. Truly, this was the best Christmas pageant ever. Thank you to all the kids who took part, and thank you all to all the parents who took part. Your role was indispensable. A few announcements I want to give you this morning. The first is that pledge envelope boxes are available in the pavilion after church today. Please, if you've requested pledge envelopes for 2024, you can pick it up there. Also, you can check the parish directory to make sure your entry is correct, make sure we have your information. If you're not in there, we'd love you to be in that directory, so please do write your information into one of the samples on that table. Advent Compline and the O Antiphons are tonight at 8 p.m. here at the church. Beautiful way to get into the Christmas spirit, as it were. So that's 8 p.m. here at the church, sung service, sung by the Compline Choir, so you don't have to sing anything. But they will sing, and they'll do so beautifully. So that's Advent Compline tonight at 8 p.m. Christmas Eve is right around the corner, 5 and 10 p.m. services a week from today. We also have 8 and 10 in the morning because it's also Advent 4. So I'm looking at you people and expecting to see you all twice next Sunday, in the morning for Advent 4 and in the evening for Christmas Eve, 5 and 10 p.m. Christmas Eve services. Christmas morning at 10 a.m., we're going to have some singers there, so there will be Christmas carol singing at the 10 a.m. service. So if you can rather come in the daylight, come Christmas morning, that's Monday, a week from tomorrow, at 10 a.m. Lastly, because we've had to move the table altar for the pageant today, we're celebrating the Eucharist at the high altar, but we will bring communion down to you and distribute it in the normal place. Just come forward, receive standing from a priest. If you would prefer to receive a blessing, just cross your arms over your chest and I will give you a blessing instead. But you're all welcome to receive the sacrament here at Grace Church. And I ascribe to the Lord the honor to his name, bring offerings, and come into his courts.
Thank you.
In your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ has come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. At the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Amen.
us stand and pray together. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for giving us the spiritual spirit of food,
the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries, that we are the members of the body of your Son, and the heirs of your kingdom.
And now, rejoice in the first advent of our Redeemer, and his second advent be rewarded with unending life. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.